holiday makeup for mature skin. We're gonna go full glam today. So I'm starting off by cleansing the skin with some micellar water and prepping the lips with the Tatcha lip mask. This is a great hydrating lip mask. And then for more hydration, the Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cream. This is a great one because it absorbs beautifully into the skin and it doesn't leave a greasy layer, especially since we're gonna go with a full coverage foundation. Now, this is optional, but I'm going in with the Skin Iceland eye patches. Very cooling, and you want to prep the under eye area well, especially for mature skin, so that your concealer doesn't crease. While that's all sinking in, I'm gonna go into the eyeshadow. This is the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. I'm using it to prime the eyelids, and as you can see, I also brought it into the inner corner of the eye where most people have darkness there. So that's a little tip if your eyeshadow looks a little disconnected. But now I'm going in with an LA Girl regular cold pencil. This is important because you can really manipulate it and it's not going to dry down fast. So I'm going in with this first to sketch out the eyeliner and shape of the eyeshadow that I want to. This is a brown color, I believe, it's not black. This beautiful palette from Nabla. This is the Cutie palette, and I'm just setting the concealer and then going in with a darker color to deepen the wing slash the lash line area. For more mature people, you want to deepen this area because you lose hair as you get older, so bringing back that dimension will really thicken and create the illusion that you have like a thicker lash line or more lashes. So I'm also going in with a black from my Viseart palette to mimic the idea of an eyeliner. Now, you can leave it matte like this, but for holiday you want to add a little sparkle. So even though people say don't go with shimmer for mature skin, it looks beautiful. This is from the Nabla Cutie palette, and look at, she even likes it. Looking at herself. And now I'm going in with a more gold on the inner corner just so that it opens up her eye a little bit, especially since it's deep set. I want to bring more brightness to that area. I don't want to use too many dark colors to make it even look even more like sunken in. Now I'm just cleaning up the under eye area with a makeup remover wipe. Just to be sure, I also go in with a cotton round in micellar water so that if the makeup wipe left any residue, it's not disturbing the concealer that we're gonna be applying afterwards. Next, I'm going in with foundation. This is the NARS Natural Radiant Long Wear mixed in with the Estee Lauder Double Wear, which might seem very heavy, but this is, again, glam, and it's going to last all night. I'm dotting it all over the skin and spraying it with some setting spray just to make it last longer as well as blend it out a little bit better. This is a technique that I learned from Hung Van Gogh's videos. And as you can see, I'm picking up whatever is left on the back of my hand, very thin layers, and blending it down the neck to make sure it all matches. Next, I'm going in with the Makeup by Mario Skin Perfector Cream and just bronzing up her skin. I don't want to add any more contours because as you can see, she has great cheekbones, and any other cooler undertone would just continue to emphasize the hollows in her skin. And as you age, you lose those that plumpness and volume in your skin, so you don't want to add any more shadows. You just want to make everything look more lively. So I'm going in with something warmer and cream, which is going to emphasize the glowiness. Next, I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer mixed in with the Kosas Concealer, very little amount, focusing it on the inner corner as well as the outer corner, and just buffing that up. My favorite blush recently has been the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Blushes and an angled brush, which I didn't used to believe in, but they are so wonderful at applying products evenly. And now I'm going in with a Makeup by Mario powder bronzer. Again, not a full-on contour, just something warm around the perimeters of her face and setting that initial cream layer. I first went in with a pressed powder and a brush to create a thin veil underneath the eyes, and now I'm going in with my Hourglass mixed with one size loose setting powder and a powder puff to really press it into the skin. As you can see, I go in backwards and forwards to make sure that the creases are set in each direction, and the powder puff ensures the longevity as well because you're really pushing it instead of just sweeping it across the skin. This might be controversial, if you will, for mature skin, but I think because we went in with the really good skin prep of hydrating underneath, it allows for us to use a little bit more powder. And I always tell the client as well to relax the eyebrow so that the concealer isn't being set inside the lines when I'm going in with a powder puff. And now I'm cleaning up the eyebrows with some micellar water to take off the foundation and powder that got in there, and going in with a brow pencil. Now, typically I would have carved out the brows and made them look like extra, extra perfect, but for mature skin, I like to keep the brows as fluffy and natural looking as possible, because the thicker the brows, the more youthful the look is going to be. So keeping up with the youthful look, the glowy skin, it all ties together. And here is the finished look, a beautiful holiday glam for anybody that wants a little sparkle and glow in their life. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and please give me a like and subscribe down below.